Hello friends, so I again welcome you all in this video lecture series, and this is the third lecture of the point set topology. Before that we have already seen in the first lecture neighborhood of a point. In the second lecture we have seen what is open set and closed set, and we have seen several counter example. This is the third lecture, and in this third lecture we discuss what is compact set and what is connected set, and also we see several counter example, and by these counter examples we try to connect with these two type of set, whether and when the set will be compact or not. Or in the similar way we will also see when any set will be connected or disconnected, and by the counter example we also justify them, right? So first we see what is compact set, right? And this lecture is basically dedicated for CSIR, NET, GATE, JAM exam, because several problems are based on this topic, right? And we focus basically here the question which are basically based on this, and later on I will also try to include some problem which are basically ask in CSIR or GATE or IIT JAM, right? Similar to them, and justify with these definition, right? So first we discuss what is compact set. So yes, compact set, any subset S of a set of real number is compact if it is closed and bounded, right? Any subset S of a set of real number is compact when we say that this set is compact if it is what? If it is closed and bounded. Basically this definition, or you can say that this theorem, is given by Henny Borel, right? This is very very important definition, and you can solve several problem based on this simple way, right? If you have any set, you just see only whether the set is closed and bounded or not. If it is closed and bounded, we simply say that it is compact set, right? And there has another definition, later on I will also elaborate this, but in this lecture we focus on this definition which was given by Henny Borel, right? This basically Henny, there has a Henny Borel property, or you can say that Henny Borel theorem, which says any set which is compact if it is closed and bounded. Second definition is also very important, and this is the basic definition, but in the next few lecture I will discuss this second definition. Here only I just define what is compact set by the second way. Any subset S is compact if every open cover of S, every open cover means a collection of basically open set, right? Collection of open set which is basically open cover. Later on I will just discuss what is open cover, and it has finite sub cover. It has finite sub cover. So if there exists an open cover of this set S, then every open cover has a finite sub cover, then we say that it is compact. This is the second definition, later on I will just discuss, but here in this lecture we, as I already told you, this lecture is dedicated for CSIR, NET, GATE, JAM exam. In most of the problem, or you can say that 95% problem, if they are based on compact set or connected set, these are solved by a simple property, right? No need to go for the lengthy theorems or lemma or other things. If you have a standard result, you can solve any problem, right? So let we just first see how we can justify this is compact. So first we just see the first counter example, right? And first example is a set of natural number. So first we have to see whether this set of natural number is compact or not. So you know this is the set of natural number, right? This goes up to infinite. Now let me know whether this set is closed. I have already discussed when any set is called closed. You know this set of natural number is basically closed. Why it is closed? Because you can directly either you can say that all the limit point is exist in this set, or you can also say that its complement is basically what? Open, right? Very simple. You can just draw a simple line, right? On this simple line you can take this point 1 2 3 4 5 in this way, and this is goes up to infinite, this is goes up to minus infinite. If you calculate the complement of this natural number, that is r minus n, if you just delete this one, you will get an what? Open set. It is basically union of what? Open set, and union of open set is again open. So if you calculate the complement of this natural number, right, it is basically open. This means that this set is closed. So it is very clear this set of natural number is closed, right? But whether it is bounded, because for the compactness we have to show two property. First, it is closed, and second, it is bounded. So this set is very clear, the set of natural number is what? Closed. This set of natural number is closed. But what about bounded? It is not bounded, because and that side you can see that it has a lower bound, but upper bound does not exist, right? So it is not bounded. It is not bounded. So you can say that the set of natural number is not compact, right? So we can say that, I just cross if it is not compact. So the set of this natural number is not compact, right? Now we move on the second counter example, that is the set of integer, right? Now this is the set of, we have already seen it is not compact. Second is set of integer. What about set of integer? You know, this is 0, 1, 2, 3, dot, 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 goes up to infinite. In the left side, minus 1, minus 2, dot, dot, dot. Now, what about this set of integer? You know, this set of integer, again, it is what? Closed. Very simple. You can draw the same thing as we did for the set of natural number. You can just calculate the complement of this natural number, which is basically r minus what? Z. You just delete this, and you can very easily see again the complement is basically open, right? You can just simply draw a straight line, and on the straight line you can say that it formed the, this is open set. In the last lecture we have already seen how we can say that the set of basically integer is closed, because its complement is open. So it is closed. Now what about bounded? Whether it is bounded? No, it is unbounded, right? You can see that this is infinite, this is minus infinite. This set of integer is again what? Unbounded. Unbounded, right? So you can say that it is not bounded. So it satisfies the first property, that is the set of integer is closed, but it is not bounded or unbounded. So on this basis we can say that again the set of integer, this is not what? Not compact, right? It is not compact set. So for the compactness we have two important property. First, the set must be closed, and the second is the set must be bounded. If these two properties are satisfied, then only we can say that it is what? Compact set, right? So now we move on the third example, that is the set of real number. So we just again cross this. This is also not compact. We have seen these two examples. Now we move on the third one, that is set of real number. You can also say very simply whether set of real number is compact or not. You know, set of real number, I just simply draw here very simply this set of real number. What about the set of real number? Whether it is closed? Yes, you know, set of real number is both open and closed. But what about the second property, that it is bounded? No, it is again unbounded, right? It is again unbounded. The set of real number, you know, this is set, right, minus infinite to infinite, right? इट इज एन इंटरवल, इट इज बोथ क्लोज्ड एंड ओपन, इट इज ए क्लोज सेट, राइट, बट नॉट बाउंडेड, नॉट बाउंडेड. सो वी कैन से दैट द सेट ऑफ नेचुरल रियल नंबर इज अगेन इट इज ऑल्सो वॉट नॉट कॉम्पैक्ट, राइट, नॉट कॉम्पैक्ट. वी कैन जस्ट सी दिस डिफिनीशन ऑल्सो बाई दिस सेकेंड वन. द सबसेट एस ऑफ ए सेट ऑफ रियल नंबर इज कॉम्पैक्ट इफ एवरी ओपन कवर, मीन्स देर हैज एन इनफाइनाइट नंबर ऑफ ओपन कवर, राइट, बट इट हैज नॉट वॉट फाइनाइट सब कवर. उसके ऊपर फाइनाइट सब कवर नहीं होगा, लेटर ऑन आई विल ऑल्सो डिस्कस. बट टू प्रूव दिस एनी सेट इज बेसिकली वॉट कंपैक्ट, यू कैन वेरी इजिली शो बाई दिस इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द हेनी बोरल थ्यूरम दैट एनी सेट आर एनी सबसेट ऑफ ए रियल नंबर इज कंपैक्ट इफ इट इज क्लोज्ड एंड बाउंडेड. सो सेट ऑफ रियल नंबर इज अगेन इट इज नॉट कंपैक्ट, राइट. वी हैव सीन दिस थर्ड एग्जाम्पल. नाउ फोर्थ एग्जाम्पल, वेरी सिंपल. आई जस्ट नॉट गोइंग टू डिस्कस दिस फोर्थ एग्जाम्पल बिकॉज दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी सिंपल. यू नो वॉट अबाउट दिस सेट ऑफ रेशनल नंबर, दिस इज अ सेट ऑफ रेशनल नंबर. वॉट अबाउट इट इज क्लोज्ड? नो. सेट ऑफ रेशनल आर इरेशनल? नाइदर. इट इज वॉट? नाइदर इट इज ओपन एंड नॉर इट इज क्लोज्ड. We have already seen in the last lecture that the set of rational number is neither open nor closed. So we can say that if it is not closed, it is not compact, right? And also it is not bounded. You know it is not bounded, right? It is not bounded. So this is also not what? Compact, right? We have seen this four example. Now we move on the fifth counter example. Now yes, we move on the example fifth. Now see example fifth. It is basically what? This set is zero, this side is open and this side is closed. What about this? This is closed or not? It is not closed set. Very simple, not closed, because if it is closed then it contain all its limit point, right? 0 is not included in that case. You know this is basically x which is less than or equal to 5 and greater than 0. It is not included this boundary point, right? If it is included in that case, we say that it is closed. But yes, we can very easily say that it is bounded, right? It is bounded, right? It is bounded, which is bounded by 0 to 5, right? Lower and upper bound, but not what? Closed, right? It is not closed. Why? If you have any doubt, you can just simply draw a line, right? This is R. You just calculate its complement. By calculating the complement, you can also that its complement is not open, right? Its complement is not open. Even this, in this case, you can very easily say, in the last discussion, we have already seen this is not closed because it does not contain all its limit point, right? So it is not closed, but yes, it is bounded. It is bounded but not closed. So what we can say on this basis? We can say that it is not compact, not compact, right? So in the similar way, we can cross this also. Now we move on the sixth example, and this sixth example is basically what? QC. I just discuss here QC. You know it is basically what? Set of irrational number. And you know the set of irrational number is neither it is closed nor open, right? So not closed, not closed. Also it is not what? Not bounded, right? BDD. I just write it is not bounded. If it is not closed, not bounded, this means that it is not compact. So in this way you can very easily tell about the compact set, right? But yes, your basic concept regarding the closed set must be clear to verify. Also the concept of the boundedness, you must be clear बिफोर सॉल्विंग द क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू द कंपैक्टर. इवन आई हैव सीन सेवरल क्वेश्चन विच आर बेसिकली आस्क इन CSIR आर IIT JEE आर गेट बेस्ड ऑन दिस कंपैक्ट सेट. दे आर वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन, बेसिकली दे आर गिवन जस्ट दिस टाइप ऑफ एग्जाम्पल, बट यस दे आर नॉट डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू दिस. दे जस्ट आस्क इन टर्म ऑफ सिक्वेंसली कंपैक्ट, राइट? एंड यू नो एवरी सिक्वेंसली कंपैक्ट सेट इज कंपैक्ट. यू कैन जस्ट गॉन थ्रू द CSIR पेपर आर IIT JEE पेपर आर गेट पेपर एंड यू कैन वेरी इजिली ऑब्जर्व दैट इफ यू नो दीज बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट यू कैन सॉल्व द वेरी इजिली दीज टाइप ऑफ प्रॉब्लम. लेटर ऑन आई विल ऑल्सो शो यू वॉट टाइप ऑफ प्रॉब्लम दैट हैज बीन आस्क इन CSIR एग्जाम. नाउ वी मूव ऑन द सेवेंथ एग्जाम्पल बिकॉज सिक्स ऑप्शन वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन, राइट? ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल्सो क्रॉस बिकॉज वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन सिक्स एग्जाम्पल इज ऑल्सो नॉट कम्पैक्ट. नाउ मूव ऑन द सेवेंथ एग्जाम्पल. मूव ऑन द सेवेंथ एग्जाम्पल दैट इज बेसिकली दिस क्लोज सेट 1, 2. नाउ वेरी इजिली यू कैन ऑब्जर्व दिस इज क्लोज्ड बिकॉज इट कंटेन ऑल इट्स लिमिट पॉइंट, राइट? एंड ऑल्सो इट्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट इज ओपन. एंड द सेकेंड वे इट इज ऑल्सो बाउंडेड. इट इज ऑल्सो बाउंडेड. इट्स लोअर बाउंड इज वॉट? LB. लोअर बाउंड इज 1 एंड अपर बाउंड इज वॉट? 2. सो दिस सेट इज अगेन बाउंडेड. नाउ दिस सेट इज क्लोज्ड एंड बाउंडेड. ऑन दिस बेसिस वी कैन वेरी इजिली से दैट इट इज कंपैक्ट सेट. सो फ्रॉम द लास्ट सिक्स एग्जाम्पल वी हैव सीन इट इज नॉट कंपैक्ट, बट लास्टली इन द सेवेंथ एग्जाम्पल वी कैन वेरी इजिली सी इट इज बेसिकली कंपैक्ट सेट, राइट? सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड दिस सेवेंथ एग्जाम्पल ऑल्सो. दिस इज द सिंपल वे टू चेक द कंपैक्ट सेट. नाउ वी मूव ऑन द एट एग्जाम्पल. नाउ द एट एग्जाम्पल इज वॉट? एग्जाम्पल नंबर 8, इट इज बेसिकली 1, 2, union 3, 4, राइट? दिस इज द एट एग्जाम्पल. नाउ वॉट अबाउट दिस सेट? वॉट यू कैन से अबाउट दिस सेट? दिस इज वेरी सिंपल. इट इज दिस इज क्लोज सेट, राइट? दिस इज ऑल्सो क्लोज सेट, यूनियन ऑफ टू क्लोज सेट, विच इज अगेन इट इज क्लोज सेट, राइट? If you have any doubt regarding this closed set, you can just gone through my previous lecture how we can show that this is closed set. You just simply draw this basically interval or set on set of real line. You can very easily observe this complement is basically open, right? So it is closed and also it is bounded. How it is bounded? The question is how it is bounded. So you can also observe that its lower bound is what? Its lower bound is 1 and its upper bound is what? Upper bound is 4, right? So this is basically closed and bounded, right? Closed and bounded, hence it is what? It is basically compact, right? So these type of examples are very simple. Even the next example is little bit different, but yes, the definition will sufficient to verify whether it is compact or not. Only you have to show it is compact, close and bounded, then it is basically compact, right? Now we move on the ninth example. So we move on the next example. In the next example, the example 9th. What about this? This is basically union of open set and closed set, right? Open set and closed set. So this 8th example is also we have seen it is compact set. Now in the 9th example, we have this set. Open set, union, closed set, right? What about this? Whether it is closed? No. Very simple, it is not closed set. You can simply draw this complement. If you have any doubt at any stage, you just simply draw this. Let's suppose this set is A and you just calculate its complement. This set is basically what? it will be 1 2, this 1 and 2, and this is close 3 and 4, right? So if you draw this on the straight line, or you can say that on the real axis, its complement is not close. Why? Because if you calculate its complement, it will be minus infinite, and this side is closed side, because we have not included here 1, and we have to delete this one. Again we have to think on this union. What? This is closed and that side it is open, right? And again we have to delete this one, we have to delete this two area, and this will be union of 4 and what? Infinite, right? So again you can very easily observe it is not an open set, right? It is not open. This is also not open. This will be open, but these two are not open. So we can say that its complement is not open, hence it is not closed, right? If its complement is open, in that case we can very easily say that it is closed set. But here its complement is not open, right? Its complement is not open, hence it is not closed. Yes, we can very easily observe it is bounded, which is bounded by its lower bound 1 and upper bound is, for both of the set separately, we can say that its upper bound is 1 and lower bound is 4, right? So it is bounded, very clear, it is bounded, but not what? Not close, right? So simply we can say that it is not a compact set. So we again cross in front of this set, right? So we have already seen this one. Now we move on the last example, right? So this is the 10th example, is the last example for this compact set, right? In this way you can create several counter example and itself check whether these set are compact or not by simply using these two property. But yes, before that your concept must be clear regarding closed set and bounded, right? Now I just give as in the last lecture I have already given one example, and many of you have replied that it is neither closed nor open, right? In the previous lecture where I have discussed the open set and closed set, many people have said it is neither open nor closed, right? In that example. So in the similar way, I just give you the task for this lecture. Basically you tell me in the comment box whether this 10th example is compact or not. Even before that you specifically tell ki whether it is closed or not, even it is bounded or not, right? So I just give this 10th example for you all. You just comment in the inbox, right, whether it is compact or not, right? So now we move on the next topic, that is connected set. When any set is called connected, right? And also I will show you later on ki which type of problem basically ask in CSIR or in IIT JAM. There are several problems, right? In the later on in the same lecture I will show you which type of problem are basically based on compact and connected set in IIT JAM or CSIR or GATE exam, right? So now next topic is connected set, right? So before going to discuss about the next topic, that is connected, I would like to share one thing. We are providing the test series and also the full course, right? For the test series you can just download our app from the Google Play Store and start your test series, right, with a very minimum charges. Also we have this test series along with our full course is also available. You can just give the 10 test series with the level wise. We are providing the test series level wise, means level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4 and then level 5 for each one, or IIT JAM or CSIR are for kit, right? As I told, we also providing the full course for all these 10 papers of CSIR, right? You can just join us with from basic to advanced. We will cover all the topics of this CSIR from basic to advanced, right? So if you are interested, you can join our full course with minimum charges, right? So here we have segregated this whole paper into two parts. These five papers, we just suppose this is the major paper: modern algebra, ODPD, linear algebra, real analysis and complex analysis, right? These are the five major paper. You can join these major five papers, and also these are the minor paper. These five are minor paper, so you can either join for this major minor major papers, or you can just join for all these 10 papers, right? These are minor paper. These topology, numerical method, integral equation, calculus of variation, and LPP, general aptitude, right? This is five paper are minor paper, right? So if you are interested, then you can contact on this number, right? So now next is connected set. When any set is said to be connected, when any set is said to be connected, very clear from its name, connected means what? If there has no breaking point, right? If it is continuous, there has no breaking point, then it is basically connected, right? So you can also say that if it is interval, you know, if we think about either open interval or close interval, right, or half interval, right, either close interval, half interval means this side is open, this side is closed. So any interval, right, is basically, if it is interval, then it is simply connected, because there has no gap, there has no gap in the interval, right? Now if it is any breaking point, if it is simple, one point is left, at least one point is left, we can say that it is disconnected set. Now the question is, how we prove it, how we prove it, how we show that this set is disconnected, right? And I think it is clear what is connected and what is disconnected set. So let go on through this definition. Any subset S of set of real number, any subset S of a real number is connected if and only if it is an interval, right? This is the you can say that the short tricks, you can very easily say that if it is interval, then it is basically connected, right? Very simply, it must be an interval. Now there has another definition. This is also definition, but in exam try to use this first definition. It will very helpful for you. Now the second definition, any subset S subset of real number is connected if it is not disconnected. And what is the meaning of disconnected? Any set, I just tell you, any set A is said to be disconnected if it can be written as a union of two disjoint open set. But this is a very lengthy definition. Means these two are any set A or S, whatever you just suppose, here we have taken S. So S is called connected, right, if it is not disconnected. And any set is, when we say that any set is disconnected, if it can be just written as a union of two disjoint open set. These are the two open set, but it must be disjoint, right? It must be disjoint. Then we say that it is disconnected. Even if it is not disconnected, then it is connected, right? So disconnected is very simply, you can just understand by this what I have just draw the line. If there has a gap, right, in that case it is disconnected. Now by these counter example, by these 10 counter example, one by one we try to understand what and when any set is connected or disconnected, right? So now first we see the first example. The first example is what? You know, this is the first example is set of natural number. We have here taken the example first, that is the set of natural number. What you can say, what about this, whether it is interval? It's a very simply, you just check whether it is interval or not. If it is interval, in that case we say that it is connected. If it is not interval, we say that simply it is not connected. So you know, if you draw this on the line, right, simply you draw on this line, real line, then it is what? It is a discrete point, right? Very clear. This one is here, this two is here, this three is here, this four is here. In this way it will proceed. Now there has a gap, right? There has a gap. And interval means what? If you take any interval, either it is open or closed, doesn't matter, but it must be interval. You know, for the interval, every point of this interval, that is lie between A and B, must be in the same set, right? If every x belong between A and B, exist in that set, we say that it is basically interval. You know, this set of natural number is not an interval, and on this basis we can very easily simply say that this first example is not connected. It is basically disconnected. So we have seen the first counter example. Now in the similar way, you can move on the second counter example. Let me know, what about this? Just think, ki what about the second example? The set of what? Integer. Can you say anything, say about the set of integer? And I request one more thing, if I just gone through the second example, try to pause the video and first you let verify whether it is connected or not. So you know, this set of integer which contains 0, 1, 2, 3, dot, 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 right? And in the similar way, left hand side, minus 1, this is minus 2, minus 3, dot, 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 right? Again, you can very easily simply draw these point on the what? Real line, right? You can just draw this on the real line. Again, these are discrete point. This is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. In this way, in the left hand side, this is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, right? So all these points are what? Basically the discrete point. Alag alag points are sab. Koi connectivity in mein nahi hai. Aap dekh sakte hai, set of integer kya hai? The set of integer is basically contain the discrete point, right? Since it is discrete point, hence we can very easily say that it is disconnected, not connected set, right? So second example is also not an connected set, right? So we have seen that two example. Now we move on the third example, that is the set of real number. So now just draw this real line. You know very easily, this is the third example, and the third example is basically what? Set of real number. What about this? Whether it is interval? Yes, this is an interval, because you know the set of interval is basically this set from minus infinite to infinite, which contain all its point between these two, right? Every point is contained in this set of real number, right? Hence we can say that it is connected set. There has no breaking, koi point isme break nahi hai. It is basically collection of what? Q union QC, set of rational and irrational, jo ki har point pe contain karega. Hence we can say that it is connected set, right? So third example is connected, however it is not compact. We have earlier seen, the set of real number is not compact. Why? Because it is not bounded. But yes, it is connected. Why? Because it is an interval. So this is the basic difference between the compactness and the connected. And by this counter example only you can learn, if you are really preparing for such higher exam, right? If you are preparing for higher education, then you must have a counter example, and not only a counter example 1 or 10 or 20 example, you have a several counter example, because there has a several, if you deal with the several counter example, you will learn more, right? Now what about the fourth example? Fourth example, that is the set of rational number. What about this? Whether the set of rational number is an interval? No. Why? In the last lecture we have already seen ki the set of rational number is not an interval. Why? Because if you draw on the real axis or real line, right, on the real line, then between any two rational, there has an irrational points also, right? Even there has a irrational point also, and hence it is not an interval. This is the set of what? Rational number. And it contain what? It contain infinite number of irrational point between these two rational numbers. So what we can say? We can say that it is not an interval. And if it is not an interval, then it is not a connected set. So this is also not connected, right? So we have completed the fourth example. Now move on the fifth example. Now, yes, move on this fifth example. And in this fifth example, what you can observe? Whether it is interval? What about this fifth example? That is 0 to 5, it is closed, and this side is open. If you draw this on the real line, we can very easily say that it contains 0 to, it is, let's suppose this is up to 5. So every point between these two is basically on this real line. Iske beech mein jitne bhi points honge, all these points are basically in this way, because you can say that all the point that is less than or equal to 5 and greater than 0. So this is an interval. And what is the definition of the connected set? If any set which is an interval, then it is connected. So in the fifth example, we can say that it is an interval, hence connected, right? So we have completed this fifth example. Now what about the sixth one? This is a set of irrational number. Now tell what will happen. If it is set of irrational number, then again it is not an interval. Why? Because if you draw on the real line to this QC, QC means irrational number. Irrational number. What about this irrational number? If you just take any point, any two point of the irrational number, then there has, between there has a rational number also, right? So what you can say? This is also not an interval, right? So this option is also completed, this example completed, and it is not connected, because for the interval, the this must be, the set must be what? For the connected set, the set must be an interval, right? If it is interval, then we say that it is connected. Now what about the seventh example? Seventh example, this is an closed interval. Its name is closed interval. This means that it contains all the points between, including this boundary point also. This is an interval which include all the points between 1 and 2, right? Between 1 and 2. And on this basis, we can say that it is connected set, right? So this example is also completed. And this is basically connected set. So from the last seventh examples, what you observed? In the first example, it is not connected. Second example, it is not connected. Third example is connected. Fourth example is not connected. Fifth example is also connected. Seventh is not connected. Sixth is not connected. Seventh is connected. Now, what about the 8th, 9th and 10th? I just give this task to you all. I have given two problems to you. In the previous compact set, I have given what one problem, and I in this case I just give you three counter example, 1 2 3 4. This is basically union of two close interval. This is union of one is open, second is close, and in the third both are close, right? So you just in the comment box properly you just write which one is connected and which one is disconnected. I just give you all these tasks, right? And one more thing, this type of practice is very important. This type of practice is very important. If you like this, then please subscribe this channel, right? And forward to your also friends if possible. Now I just gone through few CSIR problem, IR, IIT JEE problem, and let's see okay, how the problem has been asked in the competition exam or competitive exam, and how we encounter the problem, how we counter the problem if these type of problem are asked in higher level exam. Now just see, this is the first problem, and I have just show you where this is basically the question from the December 2017 from the CSIR paper, right? 2017, this question is basically, this question is based on compact set. Now you tell where it is compact, but yes, it is 100% this question is from the compact. So you have to tell the how you recognize the question, कैसे आपको question को पहचानना है, ये हमें बताना है कि ये if you are able to correlate this problem with the basic definition, you can very easily solve the problem. अब आपको इसमें कहीं नहीं दिख रहा compact net, but yes, this problem is handled from the percent from the compact net. आपको ऐसी प्रॉब्लम कैसे हैंडल करना है, क्या उसके पीछे टेक्निक क्या है, हमें कैसे पता चलेगा कम्पैक्ट है या नहीं है, इन सब के लिए आपकी बेसिक बहुत स्ट्रांग होनी चाहिए. सो दिस इज द CSIR क्वेश्चन पेपर. और ऐसे प्रॉब्लम ऐसा नहीं है कि सिर्फ CSIR, आप देखेंगे IIT JEE के एग्जाम में भी है, गेट के एग्जाम में भी है. सो आपको पहले बेसिक बहुत स्ट्रांग होनी चाहिए, उससे रिलेटेड बहुत सारे काउंटर एग्जाम्पल आपको सॉल्व करने आना चाहिए, तभी उन प्रॉब्लम को आप क्विकली हैंडल कर पाएंगे, राइट? सो नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन विच हैज बीन आस्क इन December 2013, अगेन यू कैन से दैट हियर विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सबसेट ऑफ R2 आर कनेक्टेड. अगेन सी, दिस क्वेश्चन इज रिलेटेड टू द कनेक्टेड. सो इफ योर बेसिक इज स्ट्रांग, यू जस्ट ट्राई टू अप्लाई व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू, यू जस्ट ट्राई टू अप्लाई, एंड देन लेटर ऑन आई हैव ऑलरेडी अपलोडेड सेवरल वीडियोज based on this, but yes, after this you just try to correlate, after this lecture try to correlate with this type of problem, right? And try to solve the direct problem, because it is directly seen, right? It is directly seen. इधर उधर कुछ भी solve करते रहे उससे कोई मतलब नहीं है. अगर आपको competition के exam में beat करना है तो direct question paper को solve करने आना चाहिए. आप कुछ भी इधर उधर पढ़ाया जाए उन सबसे कोई लेना देना नहीं है. बहुत हाँ, उस बेसिक से रिलेट करके आप प्रॉब्लम को कैसे इनकाउंटर करते हैं, ये आपको टेक्निक आनी चाहिए, राइट? नाउ आई जस्ट शो यू दिस क्वेश्चन विच इज आस्क इन 2019 इन IIT JEE. दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑल्सो रिलेटेड टू द कम्पैक्ट एंड ओपन सेट. आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन द लास्ट टू lectures this set, this talk about this set 1 upon m plus 1 by n, such that this m n is from the set of natural number union, this set also contains 0, right? So if you suppose this set which is basically union of two set, right, and you have to tell about whether this set is compact or open, or compact or not open. So all these four options are related to the what? Compactness and open set. You can very easily tell about whether it is compact or not, whether it is open or not. I just give you this task also. You try to solve these three questions, two from the CSIR, one from this IIT JEE, and I have also given you the examples, right? So try to solve all these problems. Try to solve all these problems. So thank you for watching this video.